Yes, thank you very much. I'm very honored to be able to present these copies of the U.S. Constitution and Declaration of Independence to the school committee here to be used. There's 1,200 copies, and there's more upon request. Kent Constitution is a New Hampshire-based charitable trust. We were founded in 2009, and our job isn't just to help young people learn about the Constitution, but people of all ages. So that's what we run, a family camp, and we've been expanding our mission, reaching out to larger parts of the country. We have a YouTube channel with many of our classes that you can access what we do over the years. And Rich Gerard is the one that invited me, so thank you very much. His children participated in our camp. I just want to relate something that happened very recently. I was going to an event in Virginia just this Friday. It was a sporting event. And a lady was passing out flyers. She was running for Congress. And I asked her, where do you find your job description for a member of Congress? And she looked at me kind of oddly. I had to rephrase the question. I said, where do you find the duties and responsibilities of a member of Congress? And she said, online. I said, well, yes, but more specifically, well, she didn't know. And unfortunately, there's a lot of Americans who have that same problem. When Scott Brown was running for the U.S. Senate, he refused to take our 10-question quiz we had at the Cheshire Fair a few years ago. So we like to believe that the students here in this particular district will be very well-versed in the U.S. Constitution. So when a smart aleck like me asks them, you know, a few years down the road when they run for office, they'll say, you could find the job of Congress in Article 1 of the U.S. Constitution, things of that nature. So we also would like to offer our services to actually help instruct. We have some incredible instructors, and we're probably an all-volunteer organization, so upon request, we'll be happy to come up and help instruct people on this. So that, I also brought some extra copies, so the people in the room here would like some. Maybe I can leave them on the desk of the mayor's office, would it be okay?
Sure.
And pleased to have a very simple. So thank you very much for this opportunity.
Thank you very much.
Some time ago, Dr. Vargas asked if anybody knew of someone who could donate constitutions to the school district to give to 8th and 11th graders. It was part of the discussion we had on establishing a civics exam. And so I contacted Mr. Shurtleff, having interacted with him in the past, to ask if he could do that. And he did. And so he saved the district easily a couple thousand dollars by making this donation. So I would like to publicly thank him and say that Camp Constitution was a wonderful experience for my kids. The first question they always ask when they leave is, can we come back next year? So it's they learn a lot, and it's a fun summer camp kind of thing. And I want to thank Mr. Shurtleff for his donation on behalf of the district and the superintendent for making it for us.
Thank you.
Okay.
I'm sure those boxes are going to be in the way at some point.
Thank you.
We can keep them there for the meeting. They're heading out that way. There's no need to move them around.
At some point, the administration's going to be sitting there.
Dr. Marks. We're on to public forum. The purpose of the public forum is to give the residents of Manchester an opportunity to address the board on items of concern affecting the community. That each person will be given only one opportunity to speak. That all comments shall be limited to 3 minutes to allow all participants the opportunity to speak, and that any comments must be directed to the chair. Any resident wishing to speak will come forward to the nearest microphone, clearly state their name and address when recognized, and give their comments. Joanne Mulligan.
My name is Joanne Mulligan. I'm a preschool special education teacher at Jewett Elementary School. I've worked in the Manchester School District's preschool program for 26 years. I love my job. In the early 1990s, I had the good fortune to work directly with Dr. Selma Deitch, for whom this district's preschool program was named. I experienced firsthand the high standards that Dr. Deitch held for our 3- and 4-year-olds, for their families, and for those of us who support them. I try hard to hold myself to those same high standards every day. So I'm here tonight because I have serious concerns about program changes that I believe will threaten the integrity of this long-standing, very important, and very successful early intervention program. I do understand the realities of limited budget resources, and as you wrestle with responding to those challenges, I just want to make sure that you have the perspective of the students who will be directly impacted by changes. I'm compelled as their teacher to be a voice for my 3- and 4-year-old students. They are silent in this struggle because most come to us with communication delays or limited to no English language. My 3-year-olds can't make themselves understood and they get frustrated. It's not unusual for them to communicate through physical means like hitting, kicking, punching, running away, that sort of thing. Many don't know how to make friends or how to be a friend. They have trouble learning because they can't regulate their bodies or emotions. Sitting, listening, and following directions is so hard for them. They're not children with the development of typical preschoolers. Most of our students have made tremendous progress with the 7.5 to 10 hours per week of intensive early intervention that our district preschool classrooms have traditionally offered. I want you to know that this approach works for them. If you talk to my colleagues who teach kindergarten in this district, you will know that Selma Deitch early learning program students